All right, as promised, my first gear video. So what we have here is a Big Angus Fly Creek tent. This one's gonna be Brandon's. They're not that big, don't mind the chicken. And with this one, you can see that it needs a little help, a little staking to hold it out a little bit. But it's a one-man tent, weighs just over 2 pounds, not that much. That is a Big Angus Cooper Spur Ultralight 1, which is my tent. And it's mine because, well, I'm the dad, and I say it's mine, but it's a little bit roomier. You see, I put a sleeping bag in there. That's not the bag I'm taking. That's just a your standard run-of-the-mill sleeping bag. So you see, that's pretty much all you got as far as room goes. Both these tents, of course, have a rain fly that'll go over the top, which does need to be staked out. So that's what we're going to be sleeping in for 5 to 6 months, you know. And there you go. Over here, the other parts of the tent, of course. This little guy. Oop. This little guy is our stove. All right, opens up. What it does is this end right here screws onto a little canister. You just turn that thing, turn it on, get the gas going, and light it up. What we may end up doing is somewhere along the trail, we may end up switching over to an alcohol stove or a homemade alcohol stove. They're very popular on the Appalachian Trail. I've never actually used one. I mean, they say you can make it right out of a soda can, and it works great. A lot of places along the trail you can buy alcohol by the ounce, burning alcohol, that is. And so we may switch over, but to start out, that's what we're starting with anyway. That's what we'll be cooking everything on, right there. So I figured between the two of us, we each carry a canister and we got one stove, we're good to go. And trekking poles. I am going to start the trail with a set of Black Diamond. Had these for a little while. I think I bought them a couple years ago when I first started talking about doing the trail again. But of course, one's, you know, I got one extended out. You know, and so they, and then of course this is what they look like all tucked up in together. And they got this little cam in there. You flip it open. Kind of needs two hands, but you just flip it open. You know, and she comes out. So that's what we'll be using for trekking poles. Trekking poles, of course. I never used them growing up. You know, hiking in the White Mountains or wherever. I did some backpacking in my youth, and you know, trekking poles weren't big back then. A few years ago, we started doing some hiking, and I didn't use trekking poles, and I started reading about the Appalachian Trail and everybody talking about these trekking poles, so I'm like, well, let me give it a shot. I found the Black Diamond ones on eBay, I think, at a really good price, so I bought them. We did a camping trip, of course, we did some hiking, and I found that I really liked them. They help, you know, alleviate, you know, some knee pain, some foot pain, stuff like that, and so I'm a believer in them. You know, we'll see how Brandon does. He was going to be using these ones right here, but as I took them out, and these are just, I think I got them at Walmart, and they're the kind where you just turn that little thing and you kind of pull it out. They don't actually have the cam lock like the Black Diamonds, so he may end up buying some other ones other than those two right there. I was very unimpressed at how well they kept. And not that they were in climate control, but they definitely were not in the weather, so they should have kept a little bit better than they did. So, we'll see. And the other thing I wanted to show you is the shoes. Okay. They're yellow. Of course, they weren't yellow when I bought them. And these are not the shoes I'll be walking the trail in.
are these particular shoes, but this is the same brand I'll be using. They're Merrell. They're obviously, you see, they're low cut hiker, very comfortable, aftermarket insoles. You know, I don't keep the insoles that come in the shoes. I buy aftermarket insoles and I put them in there. I'm on my feet all day. You see, I put some mileage on here. They're breaking out there. You know, but so I wear these pretty much every day. And so these definitely have some miles on them. And I've done some hiking in, you know, this pair. And I've had a pair before these. I did a bunch of hiking in. And they did really great. My feet felt great. I got heel and tendon problems. Yeah, I'm getting old. What can I say? But none of it bothered me, you know, between the poles and the shoes. I think we're going to be okay. So that's my first gear video. I'm getting ready to do a purchase this week, sometime this week, probably this week, and I'll be shopping the next few evenings trying to find the good deals. You know, thanks to you guys out there, you know, doing all your contributing and buying your different stuff. I'm able to do that. So hopefully we'll have a second gear video coming up in a week or so. All right, thanks.